हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ईपीजी पाठशाला। माई सेल्फ मोनिका सैनी, आई एम फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एंथ्रोपोलॉजी, यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ दिल्ली। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक ऑन द मॉड्यूल डीएनए प्रोफाइलिंग एंड इंडिविजुअलाइजेशन फ्रॉम फॉरेंसिक एंथ्रोपोलॉजी पेपर। दिस मॉड्यूल विल लेट यू अंडरस्टैंड द फॉरेंसिक डीएनए एनालिसिस, बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ डीएनए प्रोफाइलिंग and individualization, various techniques and system utilized in DNA profiling and forensic applications of DNA profiling. DNA is a chemical code which determines all the genetic attributes of a person. It is known that DNA is unique for all the individuals except identical twins. Forensic DNA analysis revolves around this property of DNA. Moreover, DNA can be obtained from biological sample such as blood, saliva, hair, etc. that are found at a crime scene. This can be used to examine relationship between two individuals and to verify the identity of a deceased person. DNA is basically a double helical structure which consists of deoxyribose sugar and phosphate backbone held together by cross link based on the complementary base pairing between bases, that is adenine pair with the thymine and guanine pair with cytosine. Forensic DNA analysis involves the use of DNA markers obtained from biological sample found at crime scene. DNA databases have been compiled by legal authorities of various countries which list the abundance of a particular fragment of DNA in the population. From this information, comparison of DNA markers obtained from the crime scene, that is either suspect or victims, then with the DNA marker of known suspect can be made to reveal the identity of a suspect. The statistical interpretation are required to estimate the likelihood that material obtained from crime scene belong to particular individual, aiding in individual identification. Therefore, forensic DNA analysis aids in the identification of perpetrators, specially involved in gang rape cases, disaster victims, and it play a crucial role in paternity testing. First, I'll be talking about DNA profiling and individualization. DNA profiling basically refers to sequencing of an individual's DNA. It is also known as DNA typing. It is a revolutionary technique utilized by forensic scientists for individual identification based on their DNA characteristics. It is different from full genome sequencing. DNA profiles are generated from biological material found at crime scene, which represent small set of DNA variations being different in unrelated individual. DNA profile can be generated by techniques which basically utilize repetitive sequences which are highly variable, such as short tandem repeats. When the DNA profile of a reference sample found at the scene of crime, which matches with DNA profile of a known suspect included in national forensic databases, then reference DNA profile is termed as an inclusion. And if DNA profile of a suspect does not match profile obtained from biological sample found at crime scene, then it is termed as exclusion. This technique has played pivotal role in individualization by revealing the variation that exists in highly variable DNA sequences in chromosomes of particular species. The use of DNA for identification is referred as DNA profiling, whereas individualization is the process when the two samples, that is an evidence item and reference item, belong to common source of origin, then evidence item is said to have been individualized and the process is referred to as individualization. It is important to differentiate between class characteristic and individualizing characteristic. Class characteristics are developed as a result of control process, while individualizing traits are not created by control process but are result of random circuit. Similarly, if DNA profiles developed from biological material match with DNA profile of known suspects accurately, this is termed as inclusion. Mutations give rise to genetic variability in DNA, and hence no two individuals have identical DNA configuration. Therefore, individualization is based on characterization of those traits which are so rare that they cannot be duplicated by chance alone. Alex Jeffries in 1984 developed the technique of DNA fingerprinting based on RFLP analysis, aiding in personal identification. The development of PCR further diversified the role of molecular biology in forensic science. PCR-based DNA profiling procedure technique has become integral part of many forensic science laboratories all over the world. This method was more rapid than RFLP technology and less prone than other blood typing methods. Moreover, limited amount of DNA could be analyzed accurately to identify the suspect. DNA typing techniques are also used to generate DNA profiles in case of endangered animals such as cheetah to track their migration and breeding pattern. Now, you'll be knowing about different profiling techniques. Various techniques and systems have been utilized for forensic DNA typing of reference samples. Initially, RFLP technology was utilized, but with advent of PCR technique, new system have developed which has revolutionized forensic DNA analysis. Nowadays, short tandem repeats included both autosomal and Y chromosome. Multiplex system are frequently used for forensic DNA analysis. The technique used for DNA profiling can be grouped broadly as restriction fragment length polymorphism analysis, PCR-based analysis, and single nucleotide polymorphism system. First, I'll describe about the RFLP analysis. RFLP, that is restriction fragment length polymorphism, was first method employed for forensic DNA analysis of reference sample which was recovered from biological material, followed by restriction digestion of the DNA sample. The resultant DNA fragments produced were of different sizes. These DNA fragments were separated using gel electrophoresis. The separated fragments were transferred to filter membrane that is made up of nylon or nitrocellulose. This process is referred to as Southern blotting. Radio-labeled probes are added which bind to DNA fragments containing repeat sequences. On exposure to X-ray film probe, probe-bound DNA fragments appear as dark bands on the film. Therefore, this technique determines variation in length of particular DNA fragment. The diagram is showing you restriction fragment length polymorphism, which was older DNA profiling technique, largely been replaced by PCR amplification of repetitive DNA segments that vary in length among individuals. The polymerase chain reaction based analysis. It was developed by Carey Mullis in 1983, for which the inventor received Nobel Prize in 1993. It is an enzymatic process that allows a targeted sequence of DNA molecule to be amplified across several orders of magnitude without affecting the surrounding regions. It is basically a molecular photocopier. PCR-based DNA analysis exhibits lesser variations per locus in comparison to RFLP analysis, but this technique has immense utility in forensic cases, as DNA samples obtained in such cases are of limited quality and quantity. This enzyme only replicates DNA sequences and does not digest or cut DNA at specific sites. There are three main steps which are involved in PCR process. First is denaturation, where double-stranded DNA is exposed to high temperature, leading to separation of two DNA strands, and single-stranded DNA is produced. The next step is annealing. In this step, the temperature is largely determined by melting temperature of DNA primers. Primers are basically oligonucleotide sequences complementary to 3' and of both sense and antisense DNA strands. Primers bind to DNA template strand at specific site and form stable DNA-DNA hydrogen bond as a result of complementary base printing. Two different primes define the endpoint of particular targeted sequence that is to be amplified. The last step of the PCR is extension. In this step, tag polymerase replicates DNA sequence with the help of DNTPs to create new DNA strands. The temperature of this step is usually 70 to 72 degrees Celsius for optimal activity of tag polymerase. The nucleotides such as adenine, guanine, cytosine, and thymine are used as a building block to develop a complementary strand to template strand. At the end of each PCR cycle, targeted segment is duplicated. This process are repeated several times to generate multiple copies of DNA segment of interest. The image is showing you the different steps of PCR, that is denaturation, annealing, and extension. HLA-DQ alpha reverse dot blot system. It is the name of locus that is analyzed for sequence polymorphism. The variation is detected with help of probes which target particular subregion within this locus. HLA-DQ alpha reverse dot blot strips were easily to use and results were obtained in a relatively short span of time. The pattern of dots between typing strips was compared in order to indicate the same origin of two samples. AmpliType PM DQA system. Under this system, several markers at different loci were analyzed at same time, a process known as multiplexing. The loci involved in this system are associated to sequence polymorphism that are detected by hybridization to sequence specific oligonucleotide probes. The power of discrimination is more limited than RFLP analysis because limited number of alleles is present in the population. It involves simultaneous PCR amplification of 6 loci involved using primers that have been labeled with biotin, which is followed by hybridization of PCR products using reverse dot plot method. At the end, there is colorimetric detection of the hybridized PCR product, that is biotin or HRP septavidin complex. This system is also referred as polymarker. The diagram is showing you representation of a polymarker reverse dot plot system. The image is depicting representation of a DQA1 reverse dot plot system. I'll be talking about D1S80 system. The system was based on amplified fragment length polymorphism analysis. D1S80 is the DNA locus that is typed. Variations were present in the length of defined DNA fragment, but this fragment can be readily amplified by PCR technique owing to its relatively small size. D1S80 system basically combined the ability to analyze limited quantity and quality DNA through amplification with variations evidenced in length-based system. Thus, any allelic differences between individuals will be evidenced by different length of the amplification product among individual tested. It involved PCR amplification of a region of DNA containing polymorphic sequences and separation of amplified products by electrophoresis and analysis of resulting pattern by silver staining or UV trans illumination of ethidium bromide to determine inclusion or exclusion. Now, I will be talking about short tandem repeats or STR. STR are also referred to as microsatellites. They are basically short lengths of non-coding region of human genome having repetitive sequences where each repeat unit is of 2 to 5 base pair repeated multiple times. As different individuals have different number of repeat units, STRs can be used to discriminate between unrelated individuals. STR sequence can be simple, compound, or complex based on complexity of repeat units. STRs are found on both autosomal or sex and sex chromosome. STRs found on Y chromosome exhibit less diversity when compared to STRs on other chromosomes because they lack recombination. A particular STR locus is moderately polymorphic and many such loci are used and examined simultaneously. Different short tandem repeats based DNA profiling system are used worldwide. In UK, Forensic Science Service utilized the SGM plus TM system that utilize 10 autosomal STR markers, while FBI utilizes 13 markers. The DNA profiles are then stored on computer database, that is National DNA Database and Combined DNA Index System of America. Commercial testing kits are available for these loci, and the kits also include a marker at amylogenin locus to aid in sex determination. The diagram is showing you 13 combined DNA index system core STR loci with chromosomal position. The image is showing you mini satellite and micro satellite DNA markers. The number of tandem repeat units in repeat regions varies among individuals, making them useful markers for human identification. It is depicting an STR, that is short tandem repeat, silver stained gel. The diagram is showing fluorescent single tandem repeat profile that is obtained from two individuals using the SGM Plus kit. Now, you'll be knowing about different advantages and disadvantages which are associated with STRs. Advantages include, it is sensitive due to PCR and it is having reduced risks of differential amplification. It is relatively a rapid process that can be completed in a few hours or at most a day or two. It is less prone to problems linked with degraded samples since shorter fragments of DNA can be analyzed. Multiplex PCR amplification and fluorescent labeling and detection enables examining 15 or more loci simultaneously, which provides excellent powers of discrimination. It is a standardized set of core loci which are widely used with availability of commercial STR kits. The potential number of loci is very large, which is important if siblings or other relatives are involved. Whereas the disadvantages of STR consist of, it has less discrimination power per focus compared VNTRs due to a smaller number of alleles and less heterozygosity per locus. It has extensive equipment required for detection. The possibility of contamination from stray DNA is increased because of the PCR amplification process. The data interpretation must account for antifacts such as dye blob, electrophoresis spikes, etc. Next, I'll be describing the Y chromosome short tandem repeat, that is YSTR markers. Since Y chromosome is specific to males, YSTR markers are very useful in sex assault cases which involve mixed stain analysis that contain DNA from both the male perpetrator and the female victim. YSTR analysis enables the DNA profile to be made in case of sexual assault in which man did not sperm because of medical condition. It can also be helpful in determining the number of male donors in gang rape cases. Commercial kits are currently available for 6 different Y short tandem repeat markers. YSTR markers show lesser variability than autosomal STR markers, hence their discriminatory power is less. As Y chromosome lack recombination, it helps to generate markers for tracing paternal inheritance. Thus, Y chromosome and mitochondrial DNA markers are good lineage markers used for genealogical and anthropological studies. Mitochondrial DNA markers. Mitochondria are intracellular organelles that can also contain genetic material beside nucleus and generate energy that is needed by cell to survive. Human mitochondrial DNA is circular DNA molecule that contain 16,569 base pair coding for 34 genes, which in turn code for synthesis of 2 ribosomal RNA, 13 polypeptides and 22 transfer RNA. Mitochondrial DNA exhibits maternal inheritance, that is, offsprings receive mitochondrial DNA from their mother. Mitochondrial DNA sequences are highly variable between unrelated individuals and they exhibit high mutation rate. The mitochondrial DNA sequence of all mitochondria is an individual that is usually identical, a condition termed as homoplasmy. However, in certain individuals, differences in base sequence are found at one or more locations, resulting in two more different types of mitochondria. This condition is termed as heteroplasmy. Mitochondrial DNA analysis is frequently preferred in cases where samples do not contain much DNA or in case where strDNA analysis fails, as there are multiple mitochondria in a single cell and each cell contains multiple copies of mitochondrial DNA. Therefore, it is possible to extract far more mitochondrial DNA than nuclear DNA. Mitochondrial DNA is utilized to type the dead cell in hair shaft, bones, and teeth. Now, I will tell you about different advantages and disadvantages of mitochondrial DNA. Advantages include, it is useful for tracking matrilineal descent. New variations arise only by mutation. It is present in multiple copies per cell. It is small in size, circular in form, and is resistant to degradation. A majority of mitochondrial DNA haplotypes occur only once in a population database, making its power of discrimination better than a single nuclear locus. It is effective with badly degraded DNA found in dead cells such as hair shaft, bones, and teeth. Whereas disadvantages include, since all the descendants through the female line are identical, mitochondrial DNA analysis cannot be used to distinguish among members of a sibship or maternal relatives. Without recombination, the discrimination power of mitochondrial DNA is limited by the size of the population database used. It has limited power of discrimination and difficult to work with, hence mechanism of last resort when all else fails or is impossible. Next, I'll be talking about single nucleotide polymorphism. They result from differences in single base unit. They occur throughout the genome, including both autosomes and sex chromosome. Every individual have unique pattern of single nucleotide polymorphism. Using mini-sequencing technique, the base at a given SNP can be determined, and once the bases at several sites at different loci are known, profiles similar to STR profile can be generated. Microarray hybridization technique helps to examine multiple SNP loci at same time. SNP analysis requires small quantity of sample and can yield information even from degraded DNA sample. Now you will be knowing about forensic application of DNA profiling. DNA profiling with short tandem repeat markers have been utilized in various aspects of human identification. DNA profiling is used to identify both victims and perpetrators involved in serious crimes such as homicide and sexual assault. It is also used in disaster victim identification. STR profiles developed from human remains is matched to antemortem sample belonging to victim or profile similarities with genotype relatives also aid in identification of deceased person. It is also useful for paternity testing to establish family relationships among people claiming right on property. DNA database for particular Y short tandem repeats have been developed in various countries all over the world, which is required for statistical interpretation of Y short tandem repeat profile matches. It can also be used in insurance company fraud investigation and to examine wildlife poaching cases. So students, let us summarize what we have studied. DNA profiling helps to identify individual on the basis of individual DNA properties. It basically examines the repetitive sequences that are variable, such as variable number of tandem repeats. Earlier, the restriction fragment length polymorphism technology was used in DNA profiling, but with development of PCR technique, forensic DNA analysis was based on PCR-based DNA examination technique and system. DNA profiling with set of autosomal short tandem repeat marker is commonly applied in today's world for proper human identification. Moreover, DNA profiling with YSTR marker have been useful for identification of perpetrators involved in rape and sexual assault. The YSTR and mitochondrial DNA markers also helpful in investigating the mass migration and ancestral origins. DNA profiling or DNA typing system are extremely useful in mass disaster cases where multiple fatalities are distributed over large area, and this technique helps in identification of deceased victims. Thus, a successful identification of skeletal remain can be established by DNA profiling. A DNA sample obtained from biological material can more accurately establish individualization of biological material of human origin because it is more resistant to degradation than other evidences left at crime scene, such as blood, semen, saliva, or fingerprints that are used to establish identification of an individual. But the collection and preservation of evidence, it plays an important role in establishing the success of forensic DNA analysis. Thank you.